It's MSNBC Saturday. I'm Alex Witt, and half past the hour, here are your Fast Five headlines. Tiger Woods says he's taking an indefinite break from golf. At least one sponsor, AT&T, says it is presently evaluating its ongoing relationship with Woods. More on the fallout from the Woods scandals coming up. Polls open at the top of the hour in Houston, which could become the largest city to elect an openly gay mayor. The latest poll shows Anise Parker leading by 13 points. Parker is a lesbian who has never made a secret or an issue of her sexual orientation. It is another working weekend for the Senate. The task, a $1.1 trillion spending bill. A final vote is expected tomorrow. In Copenhagen, Denmark, some 60,000 environmental activists are holding a march this morning to coincide with the UN climate conference. We have a live report coming up in just a moment for you. And Jewish people around the world celebrating the Festival of Lights. The eight-day Hanukkah holiday began last night at sundown. New York Mayor Michael Bloomberg helped light what is billed as the world's largest menorah. And those are your Fast Five headlines. More now on the bombshell announcement by Tiger Woods that he's taking an indefinite break from golf. The statement on Tiger's website says he's focusing his attention on being a better husband, father, and person. And for the first time, Tiger uses the word infidelity in his statement, saying he's aware of the disappointment and hurt that he has caused. Joining me live now, David Love, a contributor at thegrio.com. David, good morning.
Good morning. Great to be with you, Alex.
Glad you're here. Want to get your reaction right off the bat here to Tiger announcing that he's stepping away from golf indefinitely. Did you see this coming?
Well, I guess I'm not surprised. I mean, when you look at it, Tiger just can't win. He has a situation with his family that he has to repair, and he also has a serious image problem. You know, we have to remember that over the past few years or so, he has built up this image, this squeaky clean image of someone who's beyond reproach. And now, as a result of all of this news with 12 or so women coming out that he's had affairs with, it really seems that now he's guilty of hypocrisy. Mm-hmm. So now he has to really fix his image.
Yeah. Your article on thegrio.com, it's titled Four Ways Tiger Trapped Himself. Let's go through them. The first is Tiger maintained a squeaky clean image and people don't like hypocrites. What do you mean?
Yes. Well, what I mean is that, just to give you an example, you have some conservative Republican politicians who are anti-gay, but then it all of a sudden we find out that they're actually gay themselves. I think that because he maintained this image of being someone who's beyond reproach, people don't have a lot of sympathy for that. I think that there are a lot of athletes out there who are doing the same thing that he's doing, but they don't really put themselves up on a pedestal. Because Tiger did, it really shows that he's a hypocrite, and I don't think that a lot of people have much sympathy for that.
Okay, the next one, powerful people buying to their own hype and believe they are invincible. Is that what you think happened here?
Oh, yes, no question. We have to remember that Tiger is the first billion-dollar athlete in America. And I think that when people are in the limelight and have that much power and influence, they start to believe that they're invincible, that they can do no wrong, or that they can do whatever they want without any repercussions. I think that Tiger engaged in a lot of missteps and showed that he was not thinking clearly. I mean, just the fact that
No. I want to get through these because this reason's interesting that you give for Tiger. The third one, trapping himself, is Woods's other women had nothing to lose and everything to gain. So what do you mean by that?
Well, what I mean is that you can't really have affairs with cocktail waitresses, adult film stars, and the like, and expect to have a sense of privacy. I think that many of these women that he had affairs with had everything to gain, nothing to lose with the news of these affairs coming public.
And this one is interesting. Tiger cheated on his wife, a white woman, with other white women. How does race play into all this in your mind?
Yes, well, I think race always plays into things. You have to look at Tiger's image that he has set up for himself as someone who is sort of black, but in some ways transcends race. He's called himself Kablan Asian, sort of a mixture of different races. I think that in this society, the intersection of race and sexuality is a very powerful thing. You know that in the past, black men were lynched because of rumors that they raped white women. I think that now now in society, a lot of attention is paid to celebrities, particularly like Tiger Woods, because they are married to white women. Mm-hmm. And I think that there's a lot of attention now because the affairs with the women that he had, most of the women, it appears, are white, and that grabs a lot of attention. And unfortunately, Tiger, I think, is really falling into a lot of the stereotypes of black men in this country. And unfortunately, this is something that he brought upon himself.
He did indeed. David Love, contributor at thegrio.com. It's a great article. Thanks so much.
Thank you. My pleasure.
And for more on David Love's article on the four ways Tiger trapped himself, y'all head over to thegrio.com as well. So what will Tiger's absence mean for golf's popularity? Well, when Tiger was out of golf for 8 months last year while recovering from reconstructive knee surgery, the TV ratings dropped 50% as Tiger stayed off the course to heal. Massachusetts prosecutors believe it is the oldest person they have ever charged with murder in the state, a grand jury indicting a 98-year-old woman.